For the recreation of the Apollo 11 lunar mission as it existed in July of 1969, artists at Sony Pictures Imageworks had to do a faithful recreation of the entire area around Launch Complex 39A, as well as the viewing platform and all the way through the actual liftoff into outer space. To achieve this, we had a small set piece of the gantry, one of the gantry arms, as well as the uppermost part of the capsule on a soundstage in New York. Around that was a big blue screen that required a lot of set extensions and matte paintings. In addition, the shots where we're viewing the rocket in the distance, from the viewing area of the launch complex, was actually shot on a beach down in Long Island, New York. The only thing that was in that plate was the foreground bleachers, as well as the flagpoles and the flags of all the nations. Added digitally were CG crowds, the marshlands off in the distance, the rocket, the gantry, as well as the sky. We also lowered the flags so that we could reveal the rocket and gantry off in the distance. This required extensive rotoscoping and complex paintwork to achieve this effect. To create the surrounding environment, we took a trip to Kennedy Space Center, formerly known as Cape Canaveral, and with the assistance of NASA, ascended to the top of the actual launch tower and photographed dozens of high-resolution and high-dynamic range images and tiles to be used later as matte painting elements and textures on actual geometry, essentially creating a 360-degree cyclorama. Imageworks artists then created moving waves, added reflection to the water, and removed any modern buildings and machinery that wasn't there in 1969. Other complexities these shots involved are transitions of our digital characters within one shot from live action to CG or CG to live action. We also were intercutting between shots of live action and CG for our digital characters, as well as our environments. Some of the pieces which are practical on set, and some of which were digital assets. We had to be faithful to the behavior of the light, the behavior of the clothing, as well as all the material properties. For the recreation of the liftoff of the Apollo 11 rocket, we wound up studying a vast amount of footage of the actual event provided to us by NASA. This included features such as ice that was building up along the rocket itself and flaking off, all the steam and smoke events, any of the liquid oxygen runoff, as well as the big fire and all of the diverting smoke that was coming off the base of the rocket. To achieve this effect, we wound up using big fluid simulations, both on a very small scale for detailed work, as well as very large scale to handle the big volumes needed. Additionally, we needed to get all the appropriate illumination, the fire illuminating from the rocket smoke, as well as the rocket itself and the gantry. To create these large-scale volume effects, we wound up rendering everything using Arnold, which is our ray tracer, to get the appropriate lighting and illumination levels. Also, integrating it all together allowed us to marry and blend all of these elements in one render pass. We still had the ability, though, to render out these passes separately and adjust them appropriately in the composite. The director sometimes would ask for certain characteristics and behaviors, and though the baseline here at Imageworks is to ground ourselves in reality first, we were able to collaborate, explore, and achieve the technical and creative demands of the film.